PowerPoint is the go-to resource for many teachers for both teacher and student presentations. However, students with visual impairments, color blindness, or dyslexia often struggle with navigating and using slide decks. I'm going to show you some strategies that will help you and your students create content that is accessible for all users. It is easy to make your existing decks accessible, so no need to recreate the content. First, I'm going to open a PowerPoint presentation that I already started to work on for my orca whale lesson. On this new slide, I'm going to insert a picture of a whale. When I insert the picture, a pane opens and gives me design ideas. For a student with a visual impairment, this will help the student reach that professional level of presentation that matches their content. I pick a design that I like for my first slide. I choose a layout that isn't cluttered and easy to navigate. It automatically formats the picture and adds a text box for my title and subtitle. It is important to use the preset title so that when using a screen reader, every slide has a title that is visible in the outline view. The picture can tell 1,000 words, but for someone using a screen reader without words, it doesn't mean anything. So I'm going to add alt text to the picture. Office 365 has a great new feature that automatically adds alt text to a picture that it recognizes. The feature uses computer vision to analyze and describe pictures as you insert them into your presentations, and you can alter the descriptions to better suit your audience. To see what's there or change it, I can simply right-click the image and select Edit Alt Text. Now that we have text on our page and a great picture with alt text, let's talk about reading order. When you are reading through a page with a screen reader, it has to go in a specific order to make sense. This is true for all users. In order to determine how a screen reader would read the slide, I start narrator and then press Tab on the keyboard to see a dotted rectangle around the first item or hear what is in the first focus area.
Title text box, caps lock, habitat, map of the world showing orca whale distribution, selected. Text box.
This order should be the same as how you would visually read the slide. If the order is not correct, I will be able to easily fix this, even on existing content, by either using Tell Me What You Want to Do or finding the selection pane in the Format tab of the ribbon. In the Arrange menu is the selection pane. This tool will open a new pane where I can quickly and easily arrange the order of the items on the page. If you are using a template, this will allow you to enter text into existing content placeholder easily with just keyboard strokes. Once you have changed the reader order to make sense, go back and tab through again to ensure it is how you want it to be. Note that items need to be ordered in the selection pane starting from the bottom, so title, which is first on the slide, appears last in the pane. Starting off with designer, including alt text, and double-checking the tab and reading order is easy to do and saves so much effort on the part of our visually impaired audience members.